Roberto Blake just made a YouTube video about how to deal with your haters, and I got a few things to say about it. What is up, everybody? This is Chris from The Rewired Soul, where we talk about the problem, but focus on the solution. And today's problem is haters. Why haters always be hating? All right, but anyways, this is a response to Roberto Blake's video. If you don't know who Roberto Blake is, Roberto Blake is a creative entrepreneur. He has over 300,000 subscribers here on YouTube. He also has a big social media following. He's a speaker. He does a ton of different stuff, all right? I've been following him since I started a YouTube channel and I joined his awesome Creator Academy. And basically, that's an academy for anybody who is trying to create something online. And it's great to have a supportive community who understands. So Roberto is a buddy and we talk and stuff like that. So this isn't like a backlash at Roberto. But anyways, Roberto just made a video about how to deal with haters. He does a lot of videos about how to grow your YouTube channel, how to make money, and all sorts of different things. But he also does stuff like that kind of relates to like your mental health when you're trying to be an entrepreneur or be on this creative journey, right? And he just made a video about how to deal with haters. And Roberto and I have kind of two different outlooks on this. So in Roberto's video, when he's talking about dealing with haters, like, it's great because Roberto is very like cut, dry, to the point, like, this is who I am, this is what you get, deal with it, you like me or you don't, and I respect the hell out of him for it. But anyways, like, so Roberto, what he talks about when it comes to dealing with haters, whether it's like your YouTube channel or Instagram or even Facebook or Twitter, whatever it is, like, if people are hating on you, like, just block them. Get rid of them, right? And like, here's the thing, like, when we talk about haters, like, why are they hating on you, okay? Like, I grew up in a generation of internet trolls, all right? And I don't know, I guess that generation is still around. I used to be an internet troll, and someday I will make a video about it. I don't like to, but I do need to make videos about the awful person I used to be so you can understand what it's like to grow and become somebody new, because I am not the person that I used to be anymore. I'm like a complete 180. But anyways, like, there's gonna be haters out there, and some of them are just completely trolling. They're just doing things to push your buttons, get under your skin, and some of them are just, they're jealous, right? And like, I get that. I get that too. Some people naturally hate others who are very successful, okay? So Roberto's stance on this is like, this isn't like, you know, trying to like limit your free speech and stuff like that. You have the right to say whatever you want, right? But the other person has the right to do whatever they want too. Like, that's the beauty of the United States. So God bless America, right? Like, that's the thing. So in my opinion, like, a lot of it comes down to self-awareness, okay? Self-awareness, who you are, what you're going through mentally and emotionally, and what you can deal with. Like, I will say this, I'll be 1,000% honest with you. I have done what Roberto has does. Like, I've done that a billion times, depending on my mental and emotional state. I'm very self-aware. If I'm having a bad day, a terrible day, or even a bad week, like if my depression and anxiety is hitting me, like, I know I seem like this, you know, super cool, manly man, but I'm a sensitive dude. I get really sensitive. I get defensive and things like that. You know, I love my girlfriend because she deals with it sometimes, but sometimes I just gotta block people or unfollow them and stuff. Like, here's my pro tip, by the way, on Facebook. I don't know if anybody's ever taught you this, but rather than unfriending people, just unfollow them so you don't see their posts. I've done that a million times, and if you're somebody I unfollowed, sorry, but sometimes, like, I can't see what people are posting just because it's constantly so negative, or it's lacking self-awareness, or all they're doing is talking about the problem and no solution, or there are people who have reached out to me for help and they don't take that help, and I'm like, I'm not going to watch this person spiral downwards anymore. And sometimes for me, that's just setting up a boundary. That's setting up a boundary. Like, if you come to me for help and then I give you advice and you don't take it, like, that's on you. And I'm not gonna keep wasting my time on you because over here there's other people who are gonna take this advice and do something with it. And by the way, this is for all of you out there who are my subscribers too. I love and appreciate all of you, but I do have some people who DM me on Instagram, or they email me and things like that, asking for advice, asking for help, and I give them suggestions. Then a week or two later, they ask me the same question. I ask them if they tried any of the things I suggested, and they say no. Like, just so you all know, my time is very precious to me. Very, very precious, and I will not waste my time on people who haven't even tried provide my suggestions, okay? Because I am not here to, provide for you emotionally if you are not even going to take steps to try to help yourself. Now, if you come to me after I've suggested something and then you tried it and it didn't work, now we can narrow it down and say, okay, well, let's try this. Let's see if this works, you know what I mean? But anyways, going back to the whole haters thing, like, be self-aware. If you're in a bad place mentally and emotionally, like, block, unfollow, whatever you gotta do. Roberto said he's gonna make more videos on, like, how to filter things, so, you know, whether it's YouTube comments or whatever, so, like, they don't even pass through to your comment section if they have certain words, all right? So, one of them is just out of sight, out of mind, don't deal with the haters. And, like, Roberto does a good job talking about, like, what criticism is, because if you're like me and you get sensitive and defensive, you'll take honest, constructive criticism as an attack. And that's where mindfulness really helps me out. Like, when I'm able to sit down and say, like, okay, this is constructive, okay? They're just critiquing this. They're saying something that I could have mentioned in this video. They're saying this. And sometimes what I'll try to do is have a conversation with them, okay? So I'm almost at 400 videos, okay? And I've had some people like comment on my videos and said, you should have talked about this and this and this and this and this and this and all these other things. And I'm like, well, I have 20 other videos on that. You know what I'm saying? But I think it's really important to sit back and understand, is this a hater or is it your mental filter saying that they're a hater even though they were providing constructive criticism? Because then that means it's you and not them. That is something that you really, really, really need to work on, all right? But for me personally, when it comes to haters or flat out trolls, there's a few things that I do. One of the main things is on a good day, which most of my days are good because I'm mentally stable now for the most part, is I turn towards it, okay? I want everything to come through because what it does, what that does, and if you're in a place where you could do it too, is it builds resiliency, okay? It builds it up, it makes you stronger, it makes you have thicker skin. You're able to take this stuff with a grain of salt. So I don't filter anything, I let everything come through. Sometimes the YouTube filter catches something because somebody was just talking smack or cussing me out or whatever. I let it come through. And here's the beautiful part about having an audience who loves and appreciates you and respects you is sometimes I don't even have to reply. The other people around, they reply to it instead of me. And I'm like, oh, okay, cool. And then that actually makes me feel better because it shows me that some people are just not gonna like me, but other people do love me. And it's important for my brain to recognize that because when I get into depression, my brain tells me like, nobody likes you, nobody cares about you, and all this other stuff. But anyways, I let it come through and I turn towards it. And I do meditation practices about it. I see what kind of emotions are arising in me. I try to see what fears am I dealing with right now? Fear of being judged, fear of not being good enough. Because something I learned a long time ago is, it's not so much about what needs to change in other people as how much it is about me changing something within myself. Because I know that at the end of the day, I can't just keep avoiding these things. Because if it's not a YouTube comment, it's gonna be a Twitter post, it's gonna be an Instagram thing, it's gonna be comments elsewhere, it's gonna be a coworker, it's gonna be a family member. So I choose not to run away from it, and this is me personally, okay? I choose not to run away from it because I know it's gonna keep coming up over and over and over again. So I choose to turn towards it and build that resiliency. So next time I'm at a family gathering and somebody says something I don't like, I don't have to leave the event. I've already practiced dealing with it with stuff online. And if I'm being honest, doing this online, like via social media, is one of the best practice grounds because you're in the safety and comfort of your own home or wherever it is, so you're not like in a public setting and then all of a sudden you get hit with it and you don't know how to deal with it. I hope that makes sense. So again, like I said, nothing Roberto said was wrong. Like, it's to each their own. A lot of it has to do with self-awareness and what you're doing, but I hope some of you gain some insight into another way of dealing with your haters and how you can build yourself up more resilient, okay? And I think this is a big deal because we see over and over and over from YouTubers who are having mental health issues that a lot of it has to do with the comments and the comment sections, right? So what if more YouTubers out there could train themselves to deal with these in a more mentally healthy way, okay? Like, there's a perfect example is a guy, I forgot, you know, what video it was, but he left a really nasty comment. Like, he said, like, man, you look like Humpty Dumpty, and like threw in some cuss words and things like that. And I just like, I kind of laughed it off. I'm like, hey man, you know, that's cool. I've never heard that one before because like nobody's ever called me Humpty Dumpty. But anyways, the guy then replied and he apologized and said, hey, sorry man, I was having a rough tough day. And that's something that I try to empathize with constantly. A lot of times when people are blowing up on me, like, it's not because of me, it's because of other things. And that's something I learn more and more as I let these comments come through. All right, but anyways, let's do this. Let's leave some comments down below. How do you deal with haters? Do you struggle with it? Are there any more topics you want me to talk about when it comes to this? How do you deal with it? Like, anything you wanna leave down in the comments below, like, please do, because I'm doing some stuff behind the scenes soon and I would love to hear from all of you, all right? But anyways, I've linked Roberto Blake's video down there. I'll also link the Awesome Creator Academy, something I'm a part of, so if you're trying to build a YouTube channel or whatever it is, come on over and join us. It's a great support community, all right? But that's all I got for you today. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. And if you are new here, I'm always making videos to help you out with your mental and emotional well-being. Click that little round subscribe button. And a huge thank you to everybody supporting the channel over on Patreon, all right? But if you wanna check out some more content on this channel, you can click or tap on one of those thumbnails, all right? Thanks so much for watching. Learn how to deal with the haters, and I'll see you next time.